Hello everyone, welcome back to Lady OS TV. If not the first time when you the city shine there, make you know what can pass, make you like, make you share, and make you subscribe to the shine. And make you press the bell so that if I upload video, you'll be the first person to see the video. As you do that, may God bless you. All my returning subscribers, you all are welcome. I got the video when I want to drop, so what do not think about this video? Put it in the comment section and see you guys on my next video. Bye bye. And please don't forget to subscribe, bro, and like, and share. See you guys in my next video. Bye bye.
Is there any way that we have erred? Is there any way that our ancestors may have sinned? We confess before a congregation of the whole of humanity to ask you, O Lord of hosts, to have mercy upon us. You must have mercy upon us. We have suffered enough. We have been subjugated enough. We have been tortured enough. We have been imprisoned enough. We did not do these people anything. Our only crime is to answer your name. Our only crime is to be born your children. Our only crime is to excel at everything that we place our hands into. Our only crime is to exhibit your glory and your blessing, which manifestedly is upon our lives every blessed day. That is why they want to kill us. That is why the British want to join those of them who don't know you to destroy your creation and your inheritance. You will not allow shame to befall your name. You will not allow the enemies to triumph over the lives of your children, because you created us to exist, to worship, to honor, and to praise you. That is exactly what we are going to do when this Biafra comes. It will come in truth and in every honesty, because we remain every blessed day Chukwa Biama Binigwe whiter than white and whiter than snow. Is there any way that we have sinned that you cannot forgive us our trespasses, to enable us to fulfill your own word, which was spoken thousands of years ago, that instead of what you promised not to come to pass, that heaven and earth will cease to exist? You opened your mouth, Shukokika Biama, to bless mankind to the coming of Yahweh Yeshua, who came here and said, let your kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. Those words can never be in vain, because they are anchored upon your holiness and your magnificence. That is why in the end we know that Biafra will come, that these children that we have given birth to all over the world, and their children, and their children, and their children, as long as they give birth to them and they are Biafrans, they will worship you in truth and honesty. Through this very work we are doing, mankind will come to understand you. Let your miracle be wrought in our lives. Let us witness and behold your magnificence, your holiness, your mystery, and your grace under our command. O Lord of hosts, we call upon you. We call upon you to heal. We call upon you to provide succor to those of them who are inconsolable. We ask you to come and strengthen those who are weak. We ask you to restore hope where there is hopelessness. We ask you for inclusion where there is destitution. We ask you for one brotherhood, one camaraderie, one bone, one blood, and one flesh of your children. The Ephix and the Bibios, the Ezon, the Shekiri, the Isobos, and also those of them from Isoko. We are traveling all the way to the lands of Igala. We are moving on from there to Idoma, to Igede, to the territories of the Igbo land. All these places we dedicate unto thee. All these lands of yours, we ask you to cover it with your mercy. Because Biafra will come, and when it does, we will dance on the streets. I'm telling you, by the time that we are done, humanity will think that we are mad, we are drunk in your glory, and rightfully so, because your kingdom will come to rest upon this very earth. That very kingdom is the unadulterated, non-negotiable sovereignty of the Republic of Biafra, that your will may be fulfilled in our time. All these we pray, all these we ask for, be no other name apart from that name that belongs to you. I had in so sine bige bilone bige. He say.
That was our leader, Mazin Amdekano, praying. And that prayer is the number one prayer that cannot be replaced. And that even if I try to pray that prayer, I will not get it right. That is why I will try to be playing it so that we can hear from our leader directly. I salute you wherever you are. My name is Akparawa Nsima. I am from Akwa Ibom. Akwa Ibom is Biafra, Cross Rivers is Biafra, and we must continue to protect and defend our land. You know, today I'm asking you a very important question. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to put my phone number on the screen. I want you to call me and tell me how much love do you love our leader, Mazin Amdekano? You know, how much of a love do you love our leader, Mazin Amdekano? You know, especially for those people that is in Biafra land. You know, for me, I love our leader, Mazin Amdekano, because he cared for me. He cared for everybody, even people that does not even speak his language, even people that he doesn't even know. I can remember the video, you know, the last time that our leader was taken to, was in prison. And I don't know, I think that was the moment they released him. When they released our leader, Mazin Amdekano, he was like, he called attention of the whole world to some Hausa people that were put in the prison at the same time. He was making reference to them and said, look at these people, look at the father of this person. He has been in prison for many years and they have not been taken to court. There's nothing. Our leader, Mazin Amdekano, so much loves us that even when it's not convenient, he decided to do everything possible to make sure that everybody have freedom. You know, that is that genuine love that I see in our leader. Our leader, first of all, love us, because if he doesn't love us, he wouldn't have done what he has done, even to the point that because of the activities of the things that he's doing, his parents, they lost their life in the process. His house were invaded or was invaded, and that contributed to the death of the parents and everything. And upon that, our leader, Mazin Amdekano, did not still stop. You know, he still continue, he still, you know, encourage us, he still tell us to be strong, he still, you know, educate us and say, don't worry, this freedom is going to come. He said, Biafra is going to come, and at the end of the day, that we are going to celebrate. You know, there is no love that is greater than that. I mean, even when others cannot speak, even when others use the opportunity to make money, some use opportunity to build hotels, houses for themselves. Some even use this opportunity to become, to get political position and contract and businesses. But our leader, Mazin Amdekano, refused. There have been so many times that Mazin Amdekano refused to succumb to the pressure of the so-called elders and warrant governors, warrant elders and warrant politicians in Biafra land. You know, there have been several attempts that they have tried to offer him money, monetary value, even of, it got to a point that the presidency on their self, because we don't have any president anyway, the presidency came on radio, on a recorded live program, and said that if Mazin Amdekano is looking for a contract, he should come and meet him. If he's looking for oil wells, he will give him oil wells. Yet our leader refused all these offers, and just because he so much loves us. You know, in one of the audio, our leader talked about the love that he has for the people, that he wants our people to be free. He wants a nation that black people will be proud. You know, he said that he wants the freedom for our people. He said that even Biafra will be the last miracle on earth, where everybody will be free, where we'll have our dignity. You know, I've never seen that kind of a man, you know, that will fight to the point that he will never give up, you know. That is love. And I mean, that makes me to love him the most. You know, when he opened my eyes to understand that the challenges I'm passing through, or we are passing through in Nigeria as Biafrans, is not just because of our making. It's because we have been preconditioned to suffer. We have been preconditioned to be enslaved or to be slaves. for these people, and then they use our politicians, the warrant governors, the warrant politicians and senators, to continue to enslave us, you know. And then he said, we must be free. We have to be free from the shackles of these people. You know, that is a love, man. I mean, our leader has positioned himself in a place where he can just forget about us and continue to do business just like every other person is doing. You know, they use the Biafra movement for business and all kinds of things. You know, our leader could have done that, you know, use it to buy houses, build hotels, you know, but he refused. He said, what of what value is all this physical material stuff than freedom of my people? You know, that is a love. There's no other love that can be compared, you know, to that love that our leader have for us. Is something that touched my heart, and that is why I'm asking you, how much of a love do you have for our leader Mazinam the Kanu? You know, the love such that you can do anything, you can pay your own, you can, no matter the kind of sacrifice, you are ready to pay that sacrifice because you love our leader Mazinam the Kanu. You know, is you know, when we talk about Sunday sit at home, lots of people argue and say, oh, Sunday is not this, it's not good. When we say, oh, let us sacrifice our Sunday, our Monday, lots of people argue and said, is because if you're among the people that have this argument, is because that love is not there. Trust me, that love is not there. And that is why today I'm saying, how much of a love do you love our leader Mazinam the Kanu? This is a man that he didn't even need to do what he's doing, you know, but he made himself available, you know, to fight for the freedom for our freedom, you know, in this difficult time, you know, because it's a difficult situation where people that are supposed to do the right thing, they refuse to do the right thing. Talking about the elders, talking about the governors, talking about the senators, you know, all of them are against him. You know, look at the recent visit of these elders or politicians, you know, going to court, going to visit our leader in the DSS custody, and look at everything that they told our leader. You know, that shows you that these men are just wicked people and they never have any good thing for our leader, Mazinam the Kanu. And it's terrible. So I just want to know how much of love that you have for our leader, because we need to talk about this, because when you understand that this is a man that have sacrificed a lot for you, then you will understand that there's nothing that you cannot do for him. You understand me? There's nothing that you cannot do for him. You know, sitting at home on Sunday and Monday is too small, you know, for someone that you really love. And it's not just that you are sitting for him. You are sitting for your own freedom as well. You know, you are doing the sit at home for your own freedom, for your freedom of your people and your generation. You know, how much of a love, what can you sacrifice for someone that you really love? Because I really need to come from this angle to understand what are the challenges of people. Why is it that some people find it difficult to do the right thing? Why is it that people have missed the road? Why do people miss the road? Why is it that people have deviated? Why is it that people have the mind to have sold our leader out? People have the mind to have collected money in order to sabotage the movement and to sell our leader. You know, these are the kind of things we are talking about, you know. People that you believe that, man, they wouldn't have done this, but they go as far as doing it. What is it that has triggered them? Is it that they no longer love our leader? Or what is it? Is it that our leader offended them? You know, because sometimes we need to understand the reason why people behave the way they behave. You know, who could have believed that someone in-house will sell our leader, will sold out our leader, will sabotage our leader? You know, we know that our leader loves everybody, is a very kind person, open-minded. What is it that would have made somebody to sell our leader out? You know, what is it that would have made somebody to sell our leader out? Even as we are still speaking, people are still planning on how to make our leader to continue to remain in the DSS custody. You know, and just like I said before, guys, the fight for our leader, Mazinam the Kanu, to be released is not just, is not...